This Maintenance Minute is sponsored by AutoValue. Visit us online for more information.
Andrew Markell, Brake and Front End Magazine. Let's talk about brake lubricants and how actually less can be more. I've been seeing a lot of this online. And this online too. Simply put, you do not need that level of coverage on the back of the pad or on the abutment clips or slides with anti-seize. It's the wrong way to do it. Simply put, you only need to be covering the surfaces that are moving. Because once you start putting too much on the abutment clips or the pad itself on the back, it starts attracting dirt, debris, and eventually moisture. And this can be a noise problem all on its own. Simply put, if you're lubricating a pad, the only areas you should be lubricating are the ears themselves, right here and right here, because these are the areas that come in contact with the bracket itself and the hardware. And if you keep this clean, it's not going to attract dirt and dust and possibly seize the caliper or the pad in the caliper bracket. Also, when it comes to the caliper itself, you don't have to smear a lot of anti-seize on the back of the pad. Just apply it to the two fingers right here or any surface inside of here that might come in contact with the brake pad. That way, you're only using the minimal amount and you're covering the surfaces that make contact with the brake pad. If you really want to go at it, put a light coating of anti-seize on the piston itself. Make sure that you don't get any anti-seize or any lubricant itself on the dust boot. Because once you start getting stuff on the outside of the dust boot, it starts attracting debris, and this can compromise the materials of the dust boot. I'm Andrew Markell. Thank you very much.